Hi, it's Miss Donna with Raleigh Parks Recreation and Cultural Resources. This video is part of our At Home with Nature series, Winter in the Wilderness. Brr! Winter time can be very chilly. So what do you do when it gets cold? Do you wear a coat or a jacket when you go outdoors? Maybe you wear a hat and mittens on your hands when you go out to play? Maybe your family warms your house or your car during the winter months. But what about wild animals? How do they manage in the winter? Well, many animals, mammals like us, are warm on the inside, and it can be very difficult to manage the cold when you're a warm-blooded creature. So many warm-blooded animals will sleep through the winter, and while they're sleeping, their inside body temperature goes down and their heart beats slowly. And these animals will breathe very slowly while they're sleeping. And they don't eat all winter long. They'll have eaten lots in the summer and in the autumn so that they'll have some extra body fat to help them get through the winter. And when they wake up, they're very thin and they're very hungry, but they've managed the cold. Animals that sleep through winter are called hibernators. This process is called hibernation. And in North Carolina, we've got some hibernators. We've got bats. We've got lots of different kinds of bats. And our bats, they like to eat mosquitoes and moths. But in the winter months, the mosquitoes and the moths aren't flying in the nighttime skies. So bats would be hungry, wouldn't they? So instead, they sleep through the winter or hibernate. Let's sing a song about hibernation. Hibernation, time for hibernation. Hibernation, time for a deep sleep. In the winter, where is Bat? He's sleeping in my attic, that's where he's at. Where is Bat? In my attic he's at. Oh, 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 hibernation, time for hibernation. Hibernation, time for a deep sleep. Animals who can't warm their bodies on their own are called cold-blooded animals. Frogs and snakes and lizards and turtles are all cold-blooded animals. These animals need the warmth of the sun to warm their bodies. And in the spring and in the summer, we see these cold-blooded creatures. They're sitting on logs or rocks and they're basking in the sunshine. But when it gets cold, these cold-blooded creatures need to sleep deeply. This is called brumation. And our pond turtles in North Carolina, they'll bury themselves in the mud beneath the pond water and they'll sleep all winter long. Brumation, time for brumation. Brumation, time for a deep sleep. In the winter, turtle sleeps. He sleeps and sleeps without a peep. Turtle sleeps without a peep. Oh, 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 brumation, time for brumation. Brumation, time for a deep sleep. But not all animals sleep through winter. Some animals actually move. They move from a summer home to a winter home where the weather is warmer and drier. Moving to a warm, dry place in winter is called migration. Many birds are migrators. In North Carolina, we have some birds that stay with us through the winter, like cardinals and chickadees. But we have some birds, like hummingbirds, that do migrate. They move to places where flowers are blooming because they like to drink that sweet flower juice called nectar. Migration, time for migration. Migration, time to fly away. In the winter, hummingbird flies. She flies to where it's warm and dry. Hummingbird flies to where it's warm and dry. Oh, 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 migration, time for migration. Migration, time to fly away. But some animals don't sleep in winter, nor do they move away to a warmer place. Some animals adapt to the cold, and they continue to live and to eat in our fields and our forests. Some mammals will grow a thick winter fur coat, and many animals that do stay active in winter will have gathered and stored food in the fall for the winter months. So they'll have lots to eat. So animals can do different things in winter. Some animals will sleep through the winter. Some of them will move away to a warmer, drier place. But some animals will adapt to the winter weather. But this we know for sure. Spring will come, and the snow and the ice will melt. Our fields and our forests and our ponds will be filled with wildlife once again.